Welcome back to Tech Total Access. I'm Katie Leeper, keeping you updated as we Hokies hunker down. Social distancing is especially difficult for those suffering from mental health disorders. Completing classes online is extremely hard for those with anxiety and depression because your routine is out of whack and the world seems uncertain, stressful, and lonely. If you are struggling, the Cook Counseling Center has ensured you are not alone. The Cook Counseling Center has moved to a teletherapy model of care in an effort to protect the health of students and staff while still providing mental health services to students. Students must call 540-231-6577 and request to speak to the triage clinician. The triage clinician will then either schedule a teletherapy appointment or refer the student to the crisis consultation team. The crisis consultation team will be available to students who are experiencing a mental health emergency, have no respiratory symptoms, and can physically come into the McComas office for an in-person meeting. The crisis consultation team can also work with a student through phone or Zoom if you are no longer in Blacksburg. Interim Director of Cook Counseling, Ellie Sturgis, shared why Cook Counseling decided to make such drastic changes.
Research has shown that telehealth or teletherapy and in-person therapy show about the same degree of effectiveness. That's not our research. This research has been done over about the last 10 to 12 to 20 years. And so I think it can be very effective. With crisis consultations for students that are in a life-threatening crisis, we are still working with them face-to-face, in person. They can come to the center if they are in Blacksburg. They will meet with a therapist at an appropriate distance between the therapist and them, and we'll do whatever we need to do to help resolve that crisis.
Ellie also shared her recommendations for how students should cope with the pandemic.
You would do the same kind of things you normally do: exercise, positive self-talk, self-reassurance, showing yourself grace, doing meditation, doing yoga, eating well, trying to get adequate sleep, trying not to engage in the use of too many substances, reach out to other people, limit the amount of time that you're listening to the news, and remember the competencies that you have, and be patient with yourself as you're entering this new space. I think it's important for students to realize that they're already very competent from an academic standpoint. They've been being successful at Virginia Tech, and they know how to take Virginia Tech courses. And today's students are really very tech savvy and have that competency of how do you learn a new platform or a new modality. Remember that those are two things you're already pretty good at. You're just now putting them together in the same place. You're actually going to show a lot more competency than your professors are. They're struggling with some of these platforms for the first time also. So also show grace to them as things don't work quite as well.
Shifford Health Center is Virginia Tech's on-campus healthcare center. Due to the coronavirus pandemic, Shifford Health Center is requiring students who are returning or have returned to Blacksburg to contact them for a two-part screening. The two-part screening are for those who have traveled within the last 14 days domestically, internationally, or from Northern Virginia, Eastern Virginia, or other identified coronavirus hotspot areas in the Commonwealth of Virginia. Students must call 540-231-644 for the phone health assessment. During the phone assessment, the doctor will determine whether the student needs to isolate themselves and practice social distancing for 14 days. Upon completion of the phone health screening, the student will need to complete the VT post-travel registration form. Monica Goenko, graduate assistant of Shifford Health Center, shared how Shifford Health Center is ensuring the safety of both their staff and students.
We've changed just the setup of the clinic to make sure that those students who may have symptoms that are coronavirus-like are separated from the rest of the students who might be waiting in the clinic. So maybe a student is here for an injury or something, and so we're having those students wait in separate areas, so they are more than 6 feet apart. So they're they're being separated. We have also designated specific people that are going to be taking care of students who have symptoms that are representative of coronavirus. So that protects all of our employees so that not everyone is being exposed or directly in contact with suspected students. And that keeps part of our population hopefully healthier should individuals become sick.
Monica also shared how students must book appointments and refill prescriptions in the wake of the pandemic.
We are still definitely seeing students for other illnesses or injuries. Again, those students would call, and that way we could appropriately, you know, direct them to the right places within the clinic. We're trying to mitigate spread of coronavirus by controlling, you know, who's coming in and out of the clinic. And when they do come, we get them directly to an area that they need to be. So we're not just mingling students in the waiting room, letting them hang out wherever they want, you know. So that helps us control and prevent any spread of the coronavirus. Additionally, yeah, we are refilling prescriptions, so students can call if they need a refill for a prescription. So things like even birth control, I know that's a common one that students will call for refill. Well, we can do that. We just ask students, go ahead and call, and you can talk to our pharmacist, and then we should be able to do that for you.
As a medical professional, Monica agrees with Virginia Tech's decision to transfer all classes online.
It's pretty clear to everyone right now, looking across the nation, that Virginia Tech made a good decision. I think everyone's done a really good job of trying to protect the students on campus and our population in the community. And, you know, this is a constantly evolving virus. It's a constantly evolving situation. As things just keep moving along, there will be more changes, but I think everyone's working really well and working really hard to protect our students.
Monica explained how Shepherd Health Center would handle an outbreak of coronavirus on our campus if that were to occur.
We have guidelines and protocols that have been in place for numbers and numbers of years on how to handle emergency situations, and that would include an infectious outbreak of some sort. And so we have guidelines and protocols, and we're just a small piece of the puzzle, so we would work together with other departments, including the Office of Emergency Management, the higher up teams in incident management on campus, upper level administration, a lot with our teams to handle that on campus.
Thank you for watching Tech Total Access Hokies Hunker Down. I'll keep you updated throughout the day on our Instagram.